Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. In this video we're going to watch another demo of one of my viewers. This time we have Wallace Shawn. I found him on Reddit. His name over there is Blast44 and he asked me, just give me advice on my gameplay. He's a Gold Nova 3 right now, so it's not too high but it's not too low. And yeah, we are just going to help him today. This video consists of three parts. The first part will be us checking his gameplay. The second part will be me showing some gameplay of myself, and I will be giving advice there as well. And the third part will be me showing you how you can send your demo to me. It's super easy. It takes about 10 seconds. So if you don't want to watch the review and just want me to review yours, just send me the demo. I also do reviews where I don't make a video and I just write a piece about you, about your gameplay, and I can also do that if you want. It doesn't really matter. I'm just here to help you guys out. It's I like doing this kind of stuff, if you were wondering, and yeah, it's helping out people, I feel. Yeah, I started with my brother. He was a low silver player, and I just gave him tips, I gave him advice, and he is now a legendary eagle, so I'm pretty happy with that. So yeah, let's get started with the video right away. We are playing on Cash CT side, and we will speed up as much as we can. He went for a smoke and pistol, interesting. So okay, a smoke, I'm really happy to be seeing that, it's better than an 8. We have a full rush on B here. Kind of taking a risk here, running here, but maybe the opponents were caught by his teammates, so I'm not completely sure. I cannot judge here, but if you're not completely sure if there are five rushing B, it's maybe better to just walk a bit here, so you know you won't be, if there is still a guy baiting you here, you're going to die so easily, and of course you don't want that. So okay, interesting position here. We have one guy in B. We have one guy outside of B, and maybe, I'm not sure what the calls are, of course, but yeah, this is interesting. So you can make a decision here, okay, or you want to help this guy, then you're gonna rush in, and so you're gonna run, or you're gonna wait here. You're not gonna rush in, you're gonna walk slowly, and you're going to check the different sides. Rushing in is a viable option here. I think it's fine, because there's a smoke here, so you are covered quite a lot. And you want to help your teammate, of course, but you're giving away your position, so walking is good as well. I can see what's going wrong here already, so I will move to a... Wow, there's a bullet flying over there, that's pretty cool. But okay, you're moving right into the middle. There are four terrorists alive right now. So why you don't want to do this? First of all, this guy can kill you. This guy can kill you. This guy, if there was a guy over there, could have killed you. And this guy could have killed you. What you really want to be doing is stand over here. And then, you know, you can either just look over here, check out this corner, or check out this corner. You don't have to rush in. Now you're basically a sitting duck. You're going to die quite easily. And I'm going to make a small gamble that you're going to die here without killing anyone. So that's just not what you want to do. I will show you how you can do this much better in my video. So wow, your teammate gets 2 kills. And you're just going to die from the guy behind you. And actually, that was your guy to kill. You guys still won the round, which is good. So let's switch to the first person. Let's speed it up. Yet again, there we go. So yeah, you know, don't just rush in like that. It's just, it's not smart. It's just stupid, to be honest. You're sitting duck, and that's never what you want to be. Okay, here we have a nice B. That's an A rush, of course, from the terrorist. So interesting. You went for an SMG, which is fine, an MP9, but your positioning, I'm not completely sure why. I think being closer here, for example, being on quad or being near the side, whatever, you know, at this or maybe a forklift, whatever, is better. Why? An SMG is really strong on really close corners. So if they walk into your aim, you're just going to shoot their face off. The next guy comes, you're going to shoot their face off. Maybe they are flash, you're going to shoot their face off. But now you kind of got into a long range fight. So let's say you see this guy, right? You're not flash, you see this guy. You will shoot him. He won't die right away. That's just an SMG. It's just not that strong on you know, a long range. So he will turn around, he will face you, and maybe he will have like a chance of one or two bullets to shoot you in the face. And we all know If he has a tech 9, he's just going to kill you with one headshot to your face, of course. So that's why you want to not be on in this kind of position. Okay, there, you know, you're walking out now and no one is flashed as of now. So if there was a guy walking here, he would have shot you in the face. This guy can shoot you in the face instantly. So you're going to shoot him now. So it takes a little bit of time. You're actually not the one killing him. Now you're doing fine. Now you did fine. We are really sure that there is no one on this position, although there was one guy in that position. So, you know, getting closer, getting to a closer angle would have been way better. I will show you this in my gameplay, what I mean by that. If you don't understand what I'm saying, I will just show you. You know, don't take long range fights with an SMG. Okay, a smoke here, you switch to a M4. I'm not sure if you dropped that, but... okay, that's a decision. You know, switching to a that's a terrible flash. Switching to a rifle here. I often don't do it because I feel I can still dominate people with an SMG, and it's saving so much money. But of course, you can just switch to an M4 to give yourself a higher chance to win. Interesting situation here. You guys left A open. You started at A, and for some reason you left it open. I think this is, it's just bad, to be honest. You lost a guy and they lost a guy, but A is just so open. And there's a common, it's like fact, I feel, holding A is much easier than taking A. So why not just hold A, make them, you know, risk a takeover, and then, you know, whatever happens then, it's still way better than what you're doing now, because they will take A, then you have to do a takeover, and a takeover is just harder than holding a site, so they will have the upper hand. So it's a little bit of just hold your position here. I feel that's way better. Let's speed it up. Okay, now they took A, and now you are in a world of trouble because you have to do the takeover. You're doing that quite fast. This should be a nice kill. There you go. There is really no need to go aggressive now. They know where you are. And at this point, maybe take it a bit defensive. It's a 3-on-2. And honestly, you don't want to change this into... It's not a 3-on-2. There's still a terrorist over here. I'm stupid, sorry. But it's a 3-on-3. But you don't want to change this into a 2-on-3 or a 3-on-2, whatever. So, you know, go defensive. Go back to your teammates and get information before you, you know, you go aggressive. So this is just... This is okay-ish. Just, okay, aim. I know you're Gold Nova 3. Just try to improve it. On my latest video, video 4, I talk a lot on how you can improve your aim. So go check that out if you're interested. It goes for all ranks, by the way, guys. If you are a Silver 3, improving your aim will change so much to your rank. Here, you know the guy pushed onto A. So you're running now. You want to walk. You want to walk here. Why? You basically gave your position away. He was just waiting for you to make a mistake, and you made this big mistake by making a ton of noise. Next round. You are smoking there every round. Okay, I like that. It's not bad. That's a terrible smoke, by the way. But you know, if you smoke like that, if you smoke like this, you're kind of giving, you kind of, if they want to rush, you're kind of breaking that, but it's still a waste of a smoke if they're not rushing, of course. Okay, that was a stupid round. Okay, let's speed it up again. Okay, another one. You're being quite aggressive here. I'm not sure if, they called it, or your teammates, that it's a full B push, but you're still cautious, which I like. This is not bad at all. Okay, but now you're completely sure that there wasn't anyone in mid. So you're making sound. You shouldn't run at this point, because this guy could have hurt you. You kill him, okay, fine, but don't make too much sound. Jumping down, stay silent, wait a little bit for your teammates, wait for this smoke to clear. You want to push together, that's usually when you are the strongest, or you want the terrorist to make a mistake. So what I would prefer you do now is Maybe just check this, or yeah, you also have to check your you also have to check behind you, of course, but you just have to, you know, don't push right away. And I'm scared you're just going to push right away. This is not bad at all. It's like semi aggressive pushing. You know where the guy is. Ah, that's unlucky. That's, you still got the kill. That's nice. So you won the round. Well played. It's a risky nade. In video 2 or 3, I show you how you can throw nades better. Maybe in video 1 even. So that's something to keep in mind. Let's see if you make sound here. Throwing aggressive nades. So by now they should know where you are. Especially on the higher levels. They should know where you are. Let's see if this guy knows. Yeah, he did know. He did know. So you gave away your position. If you throw a nade like this, just change your positioning. It's super important to do. Because you again became a sitting duck. You were really easy to kill. And yeah, you went to for an SMG now. I would never do this. You know, your teammates having some rivals, a pistol here. Just go for a pistol over an SMG at this point. It's way stronger than an SMG, I feel. But this is my personal opinion. You jumping here, just don't jump there. It's hard to coach you. You seem to be making like mistakes where you're just not focused, it seems. You are making weird jumps. You are running away for no reason. It's keep more to your position. You know, that's what I want to. I will talk about that in my part. So, okay, they went for a full push. Okay, you walk now, you run. There's still a ninja on B. This is interesting. So walking here is fine. I like that very much. This is not the way to go onto a site. Why? I can show you yet again. Give me a sec. Why? Oh, free cam. Okay, so this guy can kill you. 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 And this guy, and in a second, this guy can kill you as well. So just don't do it. Push a bit different and get more cover, you know, get more cover from here. Check, you didn't even check here or checkers, to be honest. So you have to do that because now you're again a sitting duck. Maybe you did this so your ninja, we are actually gonna check out this guy. So let's pause it. Let's see what happens. This is interesting. Wow, he has a defuse kit. If he gets the defuse, I'm gonna laugh so hard. Oh, they're staying way long. No, they hurt you, right? Ah, that's so unlucky. Okay, let's go to the next round. That was so unlucky. Okay, that was so close as well. Let's get Wallace Shawn again. Okay, lost my mouse. Oh my god, I'm sorry. That was just terrible. Okay, next round. Okay, I'm gonna finish the CT side here. I've seen enough. Okay, you're slowly pushing towards mid here. Again, this is not the way to push. You're giving away yourself too much. You're becoming an easy target way too easy. There's a flash. Weird flash is not really doing anything. If you flash, you want it to have a real purpose. Now you basically flash your teammate. Wow, that's nice. That kill was nice. Okay, let's hop onto the terrorist side. We will start with the pistol. There we go. Okay, here you go for a 700. Is that? Oh, you went for smokes and flashes. Nice. I like that. I like that very much. So since you went for smokes and flashes, you want your teammates with armor to go first. Nice flash. Nice smoke. It's unlucky. Why are your teammates splitting up? You have a smoke, and a smoke on a pistol can be extremely strong. So you want to do this with all your teammates, obviously. It's just not happening now. And now where's the other guy? That's an unlucky flash. You know, improvements like flash, where to throw flashes and stuff. You know, you will just learn this over time, game sense. You can find tutorials on YouTube, to be honest. I can make one as well. But yeah, flashes are just common sense. You will get better with them the longer you play. Okay, that was again the bad pushing. You have a trouble at pushing. Okay, we will skip a couple of rounds. Okay, you're winning now, which is good. Let's find a round where they actually bought. Well, it's a semi buy from, well, yeah, it's a semi buy from the CTs. Okay, they smoked it now. It's a nice nade, to be honest. This is a nice Molotov, okay, sure, but you maybe want to use this kind of Molotov just before you push in. Why? Obviously, he will move out of position, and you kind of have an idea where he isn't, right? So you're not completely sure where he is, but if he was on site, you kind of will know that he either run away, that he did run away, or he's going to be close to the boxes over here, if you can wall hack. Okay, you're flashing here. You are alone with the bomb, by the way. I hope you know this. Just drop the bomb behind you. This is extremely risky. If they kill you, you're completely dead. Nice push together with your teammate. Let's see if you push better right now. There's no one on B, so... This is more decent pushing. You didn't really check CT, but it was okay. Your teammates already pushed over there. So I don't think the CTs are really going to do too much here. You just walk into the door. You push weird again. I don't like the way you're pushing. I'll just show you. I told you before. Okay, bomb planted. Last round. Is that the last round? Maybe. Okay, so one of your biggest problems seems to be, well, pushing. Okay. I'm pretty sure it's over. So we're gonna end the video here. The first part at least. So yeah, I will show you on how to push a site. Okay, so welcome to the second part of this video. I will be talking a lot on how to take over a site securely without dying from getting shot in your back. So first of all, I will show you how I secure a site. Let's say it's a one-on-one. Yeah, let's say it's a one-on-one, and the guy we just saw him on the last time we saw him, he was on B, so we're not completely sure where he was. Since we walked over here all the way, he can also be on A. So okay, we're coming here on A, so we want to make sure we always have cover. So first we're checking quad, then we're checking side car, maybe catwalk here. We go to the side here. So as you can see, when I'm checking all the spots, is I always have cover. So when I'm checking quad, I can only be killed if he's on quad. If I'm checking side, he can only kill me from side, basically now. Then a car, he can only kill me from car. He maybe can kill me from catwalk as well, but there is this thing where you're like going left and right, and this makes it really hard for him to kill you if he's standing over here. So let's say he's standing over here and he's starting to shoot at you. Because you're moving left and right, you become a really, really hard target to kill right away. And at this point, you know where he is. You can go and shoot him for the kill. So okay, let's continue. He is not over car, he's not on car, he's not on catwalk, he's not on forklift. So at this point, you have to take a small risk. So of course, I said he last time we saw him, he was on B. So we kind of want to take a risk that he's going to be over here or on mid, and less likely on quad. So at this point, you know, we're walking out with our gun, so we're kind of giving up quad right now. So if he is really at quad, okay, we die, but it's just unlucky. But we make a educated guess where he is, right? So okay, we're pushing through. At this point, maybe you can check quad, whatever. If you have time, it really depends on time as well. So you want to push forward. You may be checking this angle right over here. You're gonna move forward. Here you have to take another risk. So you're checking, you're checking mid here. He's not over there. Then you walk towards car here. And then, you know, you can check out sight. you can check out Quad over here, but of course you can do this a little bit different as well. So let's say we can do this running as well, because we maybe not have time. You can do this very safe as well. So let's just do the same procedure. You know, at this point you must know if he's close or mid or car, he can hear you, or maybe if he's on site, it's the same thing. So at this point you just want to plan to bomb. If he's really on quad, unlucky, you're just gonna die. But you know, you at this point you shoot, he's like 90% not on quad, obviously. So okay, we are going to move our S's towards B. And we're gonna do the same exact thing. So I will first of all show you what you did, and then I will show you how I usually do it. This is all very situation dependent. So sometimes it's a one-on-one, and the guy usually plays on A. You're gonna react different than if it's the guy that's always on B, right? It's all about situation. But okay, so you came up to B. It's a one-on-one yet again. So you kind of want to check all the angles over here. So he's not over here. You're kind of taking a risk, right? But you're checking upper here. You're checking this side. Then you want to check on site. At this point, you know, it's kind of risky, of course. What if he's over here? What if he's over here? You can check everything, right? You can even do this kind of stuff. You could, if you really want. So then you walk over here. You can check the site. And then it's very self-explanatory. What you could do here is you even check out this side. You see if he's over here. At this point, you basically can push really hard and plant a bomb. So what you did was, I find it's not so smart. So why? Just think about it. When I'm pushing a site, I really want to be shot. I want my opponent have like the least possible free kill, so to speak. So if I'm standing over here, I can be killed from over here, over here, over here, and even from a checkers right here. So you just don't want to do that. Just, you know, get into cover. If you really have to rush, you can do something like this, right? This is already a lot more clean. It's still risky, but if you really have no time, another thing you could do is go over here. You're still running at this point. You know, you're checking as many sites as possible. If you have no time to go there, you just go here and you plant a bomb. So yeah, that's really how I take over a site. I feel this is the better way. At least maybe it's not the best way, but it's the better way, and it makes your percentage to win around much higher. Because when you're pushing like this, you can also get them into an awkward situation. So let's say maybe this guy is camping on car right here, and you're walking slow, you're checking everything, so you get cover, so he can check you at car, but you can check him over here. Then you want to take the risk. You know, if he's standing over here, he's going to kill you from the back. But you know, at this point, what if he's standing over car? You have an easy frag. So you know, you just don't want to rush like a lot of people do. They rush out like this, they do stuff like this. It's so dangerous and so unprotected, so to speak, that it's just risky, and I think it's bad play. So that's everything I really wanted to talk about. I think, is there anything else? I think I had a second point as well. Oh yeah, it was about the SMG, I remember. So I'm gonna restart the round. I can do it with this, and I'm going to get myself an SMG. So let's go for a UMP. Okay, so an SMG, it's not super accurate and it's not super strong. So if I'm holding B or A, first of all, I will show you how you can push with an SMG, how I usually do it. So you don't really want to fight these battles, because you're gonna lose against pistols, even pistols and AKs or rifles, of course. So you want to get close, get those, you know, close combat fights. Whatever, you want to get those close combat fights. So instead of going to side like this, you want to do something like this. So you get these close combat fights. Same goes for here. So if you want to hold the site as a CT, You want to get angles like here, right? So when they come around the corner, they are really close and you're just going to shoot them in the face like this. Or you want to stand over here. You know, your SMG is just so powerful in close combat. And it's, I mean, it's still going to lose against an AK or whatever. But at least it makes your percentage to win a fight much higher. Maybe you could even do stuff like this. You stand over here or over here, whatever. But don't go into long range battles. For example, don't stand over here and pretend that you're going to shoot anyone coming in, because they're just gonna walk in. Even if you shoot them on the face, they will still have plenty of HP to survive. So that's really all I want to talk about, guys. Let's go to the last part. I hope you enjoyed it so far. Any questions, please leave it in the comment section. I gladly answer them. So let's go to the last part. Okay, so if you want me to review your demo, it's super easy. You go to your matches, you click the match you want me to review, you click copy share link, and it says share link copy to clipboard. Basically what this means, if you press Ctrl V, it will give you this URL. You can also paste, of course, so let's paste. It will give you this URL. All you have to give me is your nickname and your rank, and then I will be maybe you give me a reason what you want me to why you want advice. Let's say I want you to help me with holding site, holding a site. Let's say that's what you want. You just type that out. You send me, you can send this to me on Twitter. No, not Twitter, on Reddit. Maybe on Twitter later, I'm not sure. Or on YouTube. And just send me a personal message or a leave a comment on this video and I will be checking out your demo. If I don't review your demo, just send it to me again. I'm super busy, so when I have time I try to watch as many demos as I can. But if I like miss yours, I'm so sorry. I will organize this a lot better. I will just make a list of people I reviewed, blah blah blah, so I will organize it a lot better. But if I miss you, I'm so deeply sorry. Just tell me and I will I would love to review your demo. So that's everything, guys. If you enjoyed my video, please leave a like. If you didn't, tell me why you didn't. Just leave a comment, leave a dislike, whatever. But yeah, I this was me. My name is Hamstar. And I hope you guys learned a lot. And I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.